achieve.
This morning, we talked to two Eagle Scouts on what it takes to get that honor. Becky Parker is live with more. Good morning, Becky.
Good morning, Travis and Lane. We're back at the Jon L. Wanzek Center for Scouting in Fargo this morning, and I am joined now by our first Eagle Scout of the morning. This is Jordan Kaiser. Thank you so much for talking to us this morning. And first, I just wanted to talk about, so when did you actually complete your Eagle Scout requirements?
I completed them last January because I've been waiting for my friend Sean to finish his, because we wanted to do a combined ceremony.
Right, so because you're doing that ceremony then this Sunday. And so you do a big project as kind of like a cap for that. So talk about what your project was.
So I did, I made nesting boxes out at the Red River Zoo for the red pandas. The first step that I took was I went to Bell State Bank and Trust, where they have a pay-it-forward program, where I got $1,500 for materials and a donation to the zoo. And the next process was gathering people and just building the boxes. And then about 2 months after I got approval for it, I went out to install the boxes.
Okay, and so about how long was that whole process, and why was that something that you were interested in doing as your project?
I was interested in the zoo because I just liked their programs there.
Yeah, and the red pandas are cool. So why did you want to become an Eagle Scout and stick it through all the way to the end here?
There are a lot of benefits in your life, like leadership, and you can get many practical skills out of it.
All right, well, thank you so much for sharing that with us this morning, and congratulations on finishing. He's got his badge on already, his Eagle Scout badge, and they're having their ceremony here at 2 o'clock on Sunday, and that is open to the public if you would like to attend. Back to you, Travis and Lane.
All right, thanks, Becky. Turning our attention to weather,